Thank you for joining us today. I'm Rudy Stebbe, and this is Help Desk TV for Windows 7. Today, in part 2 of our series on backing up your computer, we're going to show you how to implement an automated backup solution of your personal data files to a local storage device. In part 1 of our Backing Up Your Computer series, we went through the steps on how to install the Crash Plan software. And we showed you how to select additional files or folders to back up or remove from the backup set. Today, we're going to implement a backup solution to a local storage device. This is a free solution from Crash Plan. Even after your free 30-day cloud-based storage solution expires, and you choose not to continue with a Crash Plan cloud-based solution, you will always be able to continue the use of Crash Plan's free backup solution indefinitely. So, now you're on the main Crash Plan backup menu. Now what? We're going to run through the steps on setting up your first backup solution. But first, let's run through some of the menu options. Here is where you will set up your set and forget backups. Restore your backups. Make changes to your personal settings, and view your history log. You can also set up to back up your friends or family's computers over the internet to your storage devices, as well as setting up to back up your files to multiple destinations for a truly secure and reliable backup solution. Now, let's get started. First, on the Backup tab, on the Destinations panel, you will note there are currently 4 destinations you can choose from. You can back up to the cloud on your free 30-day trial plan to Crash Plan Central. You can back up to your friend's computer over the internet if he or she has set up Crash Plan on their computer system. You can back up your personal data files to another computer, or you can back up your data to a local folder or storage device. You can see that backing up to your friend's computer, another computer, or folder are free options. Crash Plan Central is a free 30-day option that you will need to subscribe to after the 30 days have expired. Let's start by first setting up Crash Plan to back up to a local storage device. For the purposes of this demo, I have attached an 80 gig USB drive to the computer. Let's now select a folder on the USB drive that will be backed up to. First, click on the folder link in the destination panel. Here you can see the available folders you have selected to back up to. As this is our first time, there will be no folders available for use. Now, just follow the steps as displayed on the screen to add a backup folder. Step 1, click the Select button. My USB drive happens to be drive G in this case, so we will go ahead and expand drive G, and then select the Backup Crash Plan folder. And then finally, we'll click the OK button. After a moment, the Backup Crash Plan folder has been added to your available folders list, and some diagnostic information is now displayed to the right of the available folders list. This can be ignored for the time being. When you're ready, in step 3, click the Start Backup button. A backup status is now displayed showing you the progress of your backup. You can click on the information icon to display more information. Displayed now is the remaining files to back up, how many files have completed backing up, and which file is currently being backed up. The amount of time to complete the backup is also displayed for you. Back in the backup menu, the identical information is displayed for you as well. Just click on the information icon to expand the status info. And there you have it. You now have a free automated backup solution to your local storage device that will continue to backup in real time for you, uninterrupted and without further intervention on your part. I hope you enjoy today's Help Desk TV. If you need further assistance in setting up Crash Plan as your backup solution, you can contact us on our support forum here at forums.helpdesktv.ca. Thanks for watching.